Thanks, Noor. Thanks for joining. You know, you can mute yourself when you're not talking. Tofail, you can also mute yourself. Thank you, Tofail. So what I want to do today is really, you know, two things. One, how to tell the story, right? I think, you know, that's really, really, you know, important. How to tell the story. And I want to take one of your stories and see how we can make it better. I want to ask you, you know, the question and see how to make it better. Before I do any of those things, let me share my screen. Just please let me know if you can see my screen, after I shared it. I want to tell, you don't need anything to create a story. You just need pen and paper or pencil and paper. You don't need laptop, you don't need mobile phone, you don't need anything. So, you know, honestly, to write your story, you just need a simple pen and paper. And I am just showing right now a story that I wrote along with, one of my colleague, Taylor, right? For Step Up, our program, Step Up One, we wanted to create a story, which we want to send it to all our clients, you know, whoever could give you guys a job, right? We want to send it to them, right? As a video. So instead of, you know, writing a big long email, we will just send them a video telling who you are, what you do, what kind of social media job that you do, and how to create that impact, you know? So we're going to do that. Just give me one second. I just saw somebody. I don't know how to, you know, manage permissions. Just give me one second, guys. I want to see how to allow people inside. Farooq, you can also do that, right? Whenever, you know, new people are joining, you know, just allow them to come inside. Okay, so I'm just going to, you know, keep on presenting. So the most important thing is, you know, how should we, you know, pitch the idea of Step Up, right? And I want to show you the format, you know. I'll start like this, right? So whenever you write your stories, try and write, you know, something like this, okay? So this is one part. Okay, this is part one. And part one will have three separate slides. Yeah, I'm just trying to make it really easy. It will have three separate slides. I can put all these three in one sentence also, but I don't. I want to show video for this, one video for this, and one video for point number three, right? Three separate things. So the way I'm starting, I'm starting with the reason why I'm sending you this video, right? We have stepped up. That is, you know, the refugees in the camps have stepped up and now become graduates. And then I'm asking them a question, will you? So who's that? Anybody who's willing to give you guys a job, right? Then I'm expanding. What is we have stepped up? We have stepped up by reskilling refugees into social media marketeers. I'm explaining what I mean by the first two, three words. We have stepped up by reskilling refugees into social media marketers. Then I'm explaining, will you step up by giving them an opportunity to create a social media impact for you? I think this for you is not good, you know. You have to be, you know, will you step up? So the first slide is 3 seconds, second slide is 3 seconds, third slide is 3 seconds, okay? Within 10 seconds, I started and I finished my conversation, you know. Why should you watch this video? I have explained it within the first 10 seconds. See, because many times people will just watch just the beginning of whatever, you know, you're going to say. So within the first 10 seconds, you have to basically, you know, don't tell them some big story, right? Just put your ask right in front, right up front, and say, this is what I want. Will you help me? And then we explain, who are we? What is StepUp.One? There are so many refugees across the world, often with little help. And I want you to, there is a lot of things important here, okay? Can anybody understand what is 5 and what is 5A? Why am I putting 5 and 5A? Why is it not one sentence? You can answer it if you just take a wild guess if you want. Or why is it 6 and 6A?
Hello, Anish bhai.
Yes.
Yes, I can hear you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you so much. In your story, the first 1, 2, 3, yeah, you try to get attention of the earth to see this video to end.
Yes. Finally,
in 4 and 5, yeah, you are going to details about this also. Yeah. Some more.
Yes. Yes, you're right. Absolutely right. That is correct. But I want to basically say, why did I say 5? This is one statement. There are more than 70 million people stuck in refugee camps across the world, often with little hope of finding a way to support themselves and build a life outside. This is just one sentence, but I cut it into two just to show you that when you're making a slide, you know, in the lumen5.com, you need to make these into two separate sentences with only one video at the background. I'll show you, maybe you'll understand it better, right? So people cannot read long sentences on their screen. So you should always have a very short sentence, remove that sentence and put the new sentence. So this particular sentence is very long. So I cut it into two parts and I give them one part first and then another part. This will become very clear when I start doing the video. Right. And the same thing, our mission at StepUp.One is to empower people in refugee camps by doing what? By teaching them valuable skills and connecting them to opportunities that pay. Again, if you see, I cut the sentence here and then I go to my next sentence here. And look at a very interesting thing that I'm putting in number 7. Right. I say it's that simple. I mean, like, why should you say that? It's that simple. Right. It doesn't add any value or it's not like, I mean, why one slide and 3 seconds for just saying it's that simple? I think. In my opinion, it adds drama. I'm not a director. You guys are very good in doing some of these things, but simple things like this, it's that simple. What a great idea. Will you do this? These are really small ones, but it makes a huge punch. There is a punch in that, sentence, and it makes the audience, wow, is it really? Yeah, that's simple. Yeah, I agree with them. It's simple. Yeah. But why didn't we think about it? Right. We will run this. It's that simple for more than 3 seconds. Okay, or even more than 4 seconds. That's a long time. Huh? It takes like a less than 1 second to read this thing. It's that simple. But we will keep it for 4 seconds because we want people to think, oh, yeah, it's simple. It is simple, right? We want to stress that. We want to create drama, in that seventh slide, or the seventh video. 8 is, we decided that the best skill for our graduates is to teach them, social media marketing. Yeah. And slide number 9 is the skill set makes, teaches our graduates able to make an impact. Right. Now, this is very interesting. You look at this whole thing. Right. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Right. This is just one sentence. There's a very big lesson here, guys. You have to really listen to this properly, right? Ask me questions if you don't understand. This skill set makes our graduates able to make a social media impact for individual business leaders, for professionals like dentists, architects, professors, etc. For job seekers, for people who are searching for a job, it's very interesting. Right, for SMEs, for charities, for universities. So why I cut one sentence It's just one sentence, right? Into six slides. I have cut it into six slides. Any answers you guys think? Why did I cut it? You know, it's okay to cut one into two sentence, but I have cut it into six slides. Why did I do that?
Yeah, because for the smallest sentence here, for individual business leaders, for a professional, and all this is great, and it's hold a special meanings to the audience. You know, when they see is there are some outspoken things, they need to feel it. But I have another just questions for you. That is, yes. You know, when we put this skill set makes our graduate able to make a social media impact, then we have a smaller sentence here. So what I want just to know the clarification, I will keep the long sentence there, and the next slide, the smaller sentence will be moving. This impact will be there only for individual, for jobs keepers. This will be just moving. Is it possible?
Yeah. It is possible. That's a fantastic idea. Fantastic idea. I did not even think like that. Very good idea. Yeah. You know, you absolutely nailed it, Farooq. That's exactly why I kept it separately. You know, I want to bring a new visual. When I show for individual business leader, I want to show a business leader like walking in a business, you know, with a suit or, you know, in a conference room. When I say for professionals, I want to show a professional, an architect building something or drawing something, or a dentist or a doctor or a lawyer. You know, I want to show a professional working. I want to show a job seeker. I want to show a small and medium company. I want to show a charity. I want to show the video of a university. So the reason I cut this into many small pieces is to bring the visual effect, you know, where you know, the people who are watching you, when you go on mute, I don't know if it's not on mute. I think let me mute that person. Thank you. So what I want to do is, you know, I want to you know, bring that individual you know, thing. I want to bring every slide a new visual, a new image or a new video, so that, you know, when the business leader is watching, he can relate to that slide. When a professional is watching, he can relate to that thing. So for me, this is the most important thing in the video. Even I feel the sentence itself is not very nice, you know. I need to change the sentence slightly. But the idea is very powerful. Because these are the people who we want to employ, all of you people. Right, so we are pitching the idea of these people. So this is the most important thing. You know, people should relate to that. Okay, I hope you guys, you know, you guys got it, right? You know, this is very important. Okay, so what did we say? We started with why. You know, we started with, you know, who are we? We have stepped up. Will you? We then said what, you know, what is StepUp.One? What do we do? Then the third is, you know, what can a StepUp.One graduate do for you? Right? What can a graduate do for you? Right? And here we are, you know, going to tell. So fair enough, you know, you can, you know, hire us, etc., etc. But what can we do for you? Right? And then look at the way we are starting this, right? Thanks to our partners, Hootsuite and Lumenfy. Right? We are giving credit to the partners, you know, who's been, you know, really helpful with us, right? Our graduates are trained to use the top social media platforms used by top design agencies across the world. Right? Look at the way we are, you know, introducing. We didn't say, oh, our graduate will log in into LinkedIn. He will like all the posts. He will retweet all the tweets. He will do this, then that, right? Look at the way we are starting this. you know, we are thanking our partners. We are telling how our graduates are trained using the top social media, used by the top design agencies anywhere in the world, right? While also recognizing which combination is best for each individual client, right? You know, we have really told a lot of these things, you know, in three small sentences, right? And then we say StepUp.1 graduates follow an evidence-based step-by-step process which can be tailored to every client's needs and objectives. And then we say, regardless of your size or your ambition, look at how, you know, this 21 should never be 21, right? It should be a small part or comma. It should be comma and then that statement. But look how we have broken it. Again, regardless of size or ambition is again adding drama, right? It's these small things, Farooq and team, you know, that makes a massive difference in the way you direct your own stories. Then we say, after an initial brief, you know, why employ this, this is important. Okay, so this is a very important thing. Why employ us? Why should you employ us? Right? Why should you employ us? Because we have completed internationally recognized training and experience. Right? Finding the best ways for brands, businesses to achieve their social media goals. Right? Over the past 2 years, our graduates, look at this. This is again the most important part of my thing, right? Yeah. Look at this. This is the most important thing. They have built B2B sales pipelines using LinkedIn. They have built B2C brand awareness using Facebook. They have helped individual thought leaders on specified hashtags. They have delivered visual stories using videos. They also have access to technical and strategic support from industry leaders. And they are affordable. Right. I mean, you know, if there is some big, you know, things behind these statements, or 25. If you look at it, right, I'm not telling how good you are. I'm not telling, the tools that you are using or the, you know, I'm telling the impact that you can create for your clients. If you think about it, I'm not even talking about outputs that you can produce. I'm talking about outcomes that you have achieved. I'm not saying, you know, my guys can use Facebook and make you famous. No. Or I'm not saying, you know, these guys will get 100 followers on Twitter every month. No, I'm not saying that. 100 followers on Twitter or 100 connections in LinkedIn. I'm not saying 100 connection. What will you do with 100 followers in Twitter? What will you do with 100 connections on LinkedIn? What will you do? Nothing. You can't do anything with 100 people or 1,000 people or 10,000 people unless you create the B2B sales pipeline, you know, a pipeline of deals for your client using LinkedIn, unless you create, you know, a brand awareness for your client. So we are talking about the impact you are creating, right? Not the outputs that you are producing. There is a big difference between outputs and impact. Yeah, and we are telling that we can deliver outputs for you. Okay, we can easily relate this to let's say a school situation, right? A result is there are 100 children in Kuttupalang refugee camp. We can say one of the output is 80% of the 100 students are studying in formal schools, right? Yeah, they are studying. That's okay. But the outcome of that may be different. The impact of that could be different, right? The impact that it creates is valuable people who's going to go and make some big things in life, you know? So that's the impact. So we have to be, one of the statements, Tafail made is, we our children, we don't want our children to be, to belong to the lost generation, right? Because they did not have a formal education. That's an impact statement. He didn't say, we have, so many people and, only five people are getting studying. Yeah, that is also a good, statement. But the impact is we are knowingly or unknowingly, we are creating a lost generation, a generation that did not study. And that is a criminal, problem, right? So take a look at this. I will share this with you. This, then I'm saying at only $100 a month, the step up one graduates are affordable. At only $100 a month, employing a step up graduate is far more cost effective than all alternatives. Any alternatives, I think I should put any alternatives. Employers of StepUp.1 will be promoted across. So I'm then telling, I'm turning around and saying, if you employ our guys, we will try and see how we can promote you and your business and your brand. And we will provide, promotional material for your social media. So the day you employ Farooq, we will put Farooq's picture, inside your, logo and basically, show that, you are doing something great for the community, right? By working with you, so et cetera, et cetera. So this is also a very interesting statement, right? Where the global community, we are appealing to the global community, comes together to address the refugee crisis in the most dignified way. The stress here is the dignified way. They're not sending you money. You're not asking them for charity. You are saying, look, I can give you this impact and I want to get paid for it. Right? You're not asking them, please donate some money or please give me some charity. You're not. You are saying I can deliver huge impact to you. And that's why, this is the most dignified way. It's a very important thing, which, we are stressing. Then we can also work with you to support, so we are also telling, we can make sure that you are recognized by ethical organizations like ethical.org or World Economic Forum or your own government, to show that, you are supporting a great cause. And then 38, finally, to make a difference, employing a step-up graduate means that you are doing your part to address the human rights violations, inherent inequalities, and uncontrollable circumstances underlying the refugee crisis. So Farooq and team, what's wrong with this statement? What is wrong with 38? Anybody can tell me. What is wrong with statement 38? I don't know whether you're talking. If you're talking, you're talking on mute. Oh, Farooq is gone. It looks like, Farooq got dropped off and he just joined back again. Anybody who wants to give it a shot, what is wrong with, 38?
Maybe you are trying to make a little difference between each other. Maybe you can try to get.
I put this wrong because it is a long sentence. 38, 40, 39. To your part. To address the human rights violations.
Yeah.
Like this. This is better. This is a better way to, make your story. You see what I did? I converted one long sentence multiple things. Farooq, I think you also dropped off, right? I think if, you know, I don't know whether other people can do it. If somebody is waiting on the lobby while I'm speaking, please, if you don't mind, right? All our graduates want us to...
Please, Farooq has dropped accidentally. Please join him again in the meeting. He couldn't connect from his side.
Okay. No, but he's already come back, actually. You know, I put him again the file. He's already back. Yeah. Can you guys see my screen? Can you guys see my screen? Farooq, you're back, right?
And also Saidul has dropped again. So okay. He's sending message to add him in the meeting.
Yeah, Saidul is not there. He's not yet joined. No, don't worry. As soon as he comes, we'll let him in, you know. He's not
yet. I already add him.
Oh, you already let him. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Okay. Can you guys see my screen? My, you know, story screen?
No, we can't see.
No, you can't see?
No.
We can see your screen, yeah.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Okay, then all our graduates, you know, then, you know, it's okay. Will you step up? I'm finishing with what I started. Will you step up? Are you interested in employing a graduate or know someone that might be? Right, 42. 43, you can find more information or contact me. 45, we have stepped up, will you? This is exactly what I started with. Number one, we have stepped up, will you? Number 46, 45, we have stepped up, will you? Same thing, what I started with, right? Now, this is a story. Tell me how many, this thing, can somebody tell me how long this will take? When we create the story and we, you know, yes, Saidul also is back. Okay. When we create the story and when we, you know, run it like a movie, can anybody make a guess how long the story will take to run?
For me, I think it will take 4 to 5 minutes.
Okay. So the rule of thumb, yeah, that's perfect, right? That is almost perfect, right? The rule of thumb is I want every slide, okay? Because I've cut it in such a way, nicely cut it. I want every slide not more than 4 to 5 seconds maximum. Some slides will be just 2 seconds, okay? Let me show you. Okay, so this one, right? You know, the individual thing, right? To create an effect, you have to, you know, just show each one of them only for 2 seconds. Individual leaders, 2 seconds. Professionals, 2 seconds. Job seekers, 2 seconds. Right? So you have to move very quickly with these. Right? But to create drama, you will enhance this for 4 seconds. Is that fair, guys? So this will be, when we create this 45 slides, each somewhere between 3 to 5 seconds will be at least 3 minutes to 4 minutes video, at least, right? Of course, you can cut it down and et cetera, which we will do, right? But this is how long it will take. So now I hope, you know, you guys get a sense of, you know, what is, I'll just, you know, go back to our thing, right? You know, now you understand what I mean by creating a story, because, you know, initially I created a Mickey Mouse story, right? you know, last week when I trained you, you know, it was a simple, you know, simple story, you know, really simple story. And you guys also, you know, created nice stories, but this is how, you know, the one that I showed you just now, is how it needs to be, you know, it has to have a, you know, an impactful beginning. You know, can somebody tell me, I'll just show again, you know, the thing, okay, share the content. You remember, Tofail, you know, I was beating you again and again, saying, you know, where is your call to action? You know, great, you are telling one story, right? But what do you want people to do after looking at the damn video? You know, people spend 2 minutes, 3 minutes watching your video. What do you want them to do? Share the video, like the video. Is that what you want them to do? right? So you have to ask.
Yeah, at the end of the story, I have asked them, please provide formal education, please provide systematic schools, please provide safer place to learn or proper educational opportunities. So I have written at them such kind of things. So
no, absolutely.
So those are, yeah.
That's very important. That's very important. I think, you know,
yeah.
We need to definitely, you know, take your story and, you know, put it. But I really think, you know, it is not the technology which is a big problem. You know, the problem is, you know, you have to write the most beautiful story. If you write the story, then the technology will help you. You know, if your story is poor, then no amount of technology can make it look, you know, big or this thing, right?
Right.
So what can we do now? We can basically take your story. Farooq, do you have, you know, any other story that you want to take? Because my story is this, right? This is the last thing that, you know, Tofail has sent me, right? This is the last one. I didn't get anything after that. So this is the last one.
You have one from Tufail and I have one from Saidul. Actually, he wanted to make a documentary, which I'm still thinking how to make it. Mm-hmm. So one documentary. I don't know how to make documentary with these things. Mm-hmm. But I am a little bit confused. So first of all, we need to work on Tufail's one first, and then maybe we can discuss with this one.
Okay. You see what I'm doing, right? You know, you guys know this very well. I just copied Tufail's story. I'm pasting Tufail's story here, right? And then I'm saying, you know, go. But look, actually, I don't want to do this. You know, I want to simply, you know, skip all these things, right? Because I have to keep on deleting everything. I always choose the YouTube one because it gives me 3 minutes. I like this focus. You know, this focus is my favorite, so I always choose focus. And it is, you know, bringing up the thing. And it is now showing me the story, which I'll delete. And I will put, what happened? Oh, God. Okay. So I need to control C, control V one by one, is it? What happened? Yeah, good.
Wow.
Super. So I just pasted, you know, hey, one more thing. Look at this, right? I don't know whether, Farooq, this is just not what I wanted to teach you, but I have installed a product called Grammarly in my thing. So it checks my grammar and tells, you know, that you have to put a comma here and this labor spelling is wrong. Instead of using since here, use for, right? International spelling is wrong. No, it's just, you know, it's a good thing. If you install this Grammarly in your computer, it'll just keep on correcting all your mistakes. Just a small.
It's very helpful. Yeah.
Because, you know, none of us are perfect, right? So the first thing you need to do is, you know, the title, right? What is the title, you know, that you want to, you know, create for this? What is the most impactful title we can give for this?
Proper education can be best investment for the refugees. Is it like this?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's a very nice title, right? Nice formal title. But I always prefer, you know, provocative titles like this. You know, I will say the lost generation. I mean, you know, please, you know, just my, you know, imagination, right? Something like this. I will create a title like this. I mean, you know, nobody can understand what you're going to say. You know, it is a little bit of intrigue, you know, what's going to come after this title, right? Then you explain what I want to do. You know, this is the one, right? Lack of educational of making Rohingya dark in the world's largest, you know. What will you do with the statement? It's too big. So chop it. Lack of educational opportunities, making Rohingya refugee children's future even more darker in the world's refugee camp. Fair enough, you know, we'll just leave it like that. You know, it's not terrible, you know. You can cut it and do all those things, you know. 400,000. See, I'm not going to, you know, teach you how to pick up the right video for each one of these things, right? We've already learned all those things. What I want to do is something different today. I want to show you the mistakes that we make and then, you know, how to correct it, right? For example, both these sentences are longer. So what I'll do, you know, please take a note of this, Farooq and team. Look at what I'm doing. I'm adding something called a sub scene. Okay, there is a small plus button here. I hope you can see this. I can just add the plus button, right? And then I can just say, I can even more darker. In the world's largest refugee camp, I'll just cut it and I'll just put it here. Right? So slide number 2 and this 2.1 will have the same visual. Okay? So let me just show you how it works. Let's say it's about education. So let's say I'm going to pick something on education. You know, just for the heck of it, right? And I'll just take this and put it over here, okay? So see what happens for team, you know? So when I run this, did you see what happened? You know, that one statement got cut into two, right? But the video behind is exactly the same. Were you able to notice that, Farooq? It's the same video, but two statements. Yeah, so this is the best way to cut things. So I'm just going to show you another time. 400 the children out of 1 million Rohingya refugees don't have access to formal education in the world's largest refugee camp, right? You know, the world's largest refugee camp is a repetition. So, you know, we don't need to, you know, repeat it again. Out of 1 million, you know, I'll just, you know, this is, you know, pausing for effect, right? What's happening here? You know, 400,000 children, right? I'll put a comma here. 400,000 children out of 1 million Rohingya refugees don't have access, right? So I'm just, you know, simply but these are not the right things. I'm just showing you so that, you know, you understand the difference, right? So the first line comes like this. And then the second line, you know, there is the first video and then the second video. It's really, you know, important to cut it so that, you know, you can do this, right? And then you can do all of these things, right? You know, quickly you can do all of these things, just cut and paste, you know, it's not a big deal at all. I just wanted to show you how you split each sentence. And I also want to show you that do not be very, very, very careful about the time. You know, this whole thing should not be 10 seconds. You know, it is right now 10 seconds. You know, don't give it more than, the first slide is 3 or 4 seconds. The second slide is 2, so 6 maximum, right? The same thing, you know, for this also, 6 seconds. So the video has to be, you know, super crisp. Okay, so that's the most important thing that I wanted to, you know, show you. Other than that, I think we've already learned everything from last week. So you just have to keep, cutting these things and pasting it here. You can just use it by, you know, using the plus button. But I don't like to do that. I always Control C, use this plus button here, and then, you know, paste it like this. Control V. Right, and then choose the preview layout, etc. One more thing, Farooq, I don't know whether you probably have seen it. Say, for example, where this sentence is coming, you know, the sentence is coming here, you know, this one, and it's blocking the book. So what I will do, two things. I'll try to move the sentence, you know, here on the top. Okay. So how I can do that is, you know, two way. There is this text position and top left hand corner. Okay, it's moved over there. And similarly, this one, I want to move it, you know, somewhere else on the top right hand corner like this. It's moved. And similarly, I want to highlight 400,000 children. Highlight. I want to highlight formal education. Highlight. Right? Don't highlight more than two words in a slide. Huh? It, otherwise, it becomes too much. So maximum two words in a slide, right? Yeah, so that's pretty much it, guys. You know, I might miss a few things here and there, but I think that is it, you know. Just keep on working on it. But what I really wanted to, you know, teach is the story. And see, this, you know, please provide these refugee children with formal schools, quality, you know. So I'm just running to the end of the presentation. Okay, so this is, let's say this is the end. And let's say this is how you are planning to end it. Please provide these refugee children with whatever, right? Quality education, et cetera, et cetera. Now, for me, that is not good, you know, because, you know, who's going to look at this, right? And what can they do? I want, this is a statement that somebody can make in the UN Council, where, you know, these matters are being discussed, and then, you know, they might, but, you know, we are creating, you know, something, and we want some practical solutions, you know, in the next 1 week, in the next 2 weeks, in the next 1 month, right? So my advice to you guys is, you know, figure out a way to ask for things that somebody can give, right? You know, that's why, you know, I kept telling, you know, so for example, you know, I told you about the various, you know, you can say something like this, right? The whole world is shut down, right? The whole world is shut down. Everybody is learning from home, right? What are the top schools doing? You know, the top schools in the US and the most advanced countries, how are they teaching their children? How are the top schools in the whole world where all the, you know, things are locked down? How are they teaching? Why can't you teach the same way to us? Right? Because we can also learn from the best teachers. Right? You can make some of these challenging statements, right? You know, what are the other refugee camps in the world doing? Right? Can we not learn from them? So I want you to, you know, build a story. So you saw the story that we said, right? You know, it is, this is a very long story, but, you know, more than 40 points. But it has the flow, you know? So that is what, you know, we also wanted to, you know, show you. So I'll pause here for a minute because, you know, it's important to, you know, challenge, keep on challenging. You can put 10 challenges here like this, you know, you don't even need answers. Huh? What are the, you know, like this, right? What are the other refugee camps doing about their education? Like this, right? You can say, with all schools lockdown, how does the children of first world countries like America, right, study? You know, just ask questions. Ask, you know, 20 questions like this, because you are just, you know, you are illuminating people, you know, and name organizations. For example, you can name organizations like I told about, you know, learningequality.org, right? Many such organizations. So that's how I wanted to do Tofile. You know, your story is very powerful. I want to personally, you know, work with you and see how to make that story, you know, a very big story, a real big story, not some Mickey Mouse story, right? Not a small little story. We need a big challenging story. The education problem of Rohingya is very big. So we need to make a big story, throw a lot of ideas, and make it count. Yeah, I'll just pause here because I want to make sure that, you know, Farooq, you also wanted to, you know, work on a documentary, right? I'll just pause it. You know, maybe you guys can come on video now so that we see each other a little bit. And then, you know, ask your question, Farooq. You wanted to, you know, but before the Tofile, you know, what do you think, you know, before I, you know, do you have any thoughts, Tofile? It's your story, so Tofile, you are on mute.
As this is my first story, I didn't know how to make a story before, but right now I got some ideas and knowledge is how to start a story and how to end that story. That people will have more interest on such kind of a story. So in the future, I hope I will do more better. Yeah.
No. Your first story itself is a super hit story. You know, we really like it.
Thank you.
It's really good story. We are only discussing how to make it better. Yeah. We're not saying your first story is bad.
That's
mean then that Tofile needs your help and his by also. That's why. So.
Sure, Kasim. Sure. You know, I'm sure he needs my help, but you know, want to help you to help yourself. You know, I don't want to write your story. I will keep on giving ideas. I want you to do it. I want you to, you know, I will keep on telling what to do, how to do, but you have to do it. Because only then you will learn. You cannot learn. If I do your job, then, you know, you will not be able to learn. So you have to do it. Any more questions before we move to Farooq? So, you know, I will share the Word document, you know, the Word document I put, you know, where, why, who, what, you know, that five wives and one husband, you know, that Shabnam taught us last time. So I will you know, put that also, you know, share it with you so you can get some inspiration. Yeah, Farooq, back to you, Farooq. You know, you wanted to ask, you know, how to create a documentary, you know.
So, first of all, what I want to say, you know, after having today's conference, I just learned how to make a fruitful video that will be very outcome from the audience. And so, for example, if we say less rents give formal education, so the larger viewer, larger audience, they are not the authority to give the formal education. So what we need to do, we can either say raise your voice, raise your voice from your end, or donate to UNHCR or donate to Bangladesh, so that they can arrange a formal school in for the refugees, or do something that bypass the so-called infrastructural educational system there, rather than we become habituated to learn from the outside world. You know, if Bangladesh is not allowing us formal schooling, then what about the other countries? If they allow us for the distance education, we can enroll there, and then we can have the formal certificate and something like that. So that's very interesting. So I think Tofile and me, I will be working with Tofile based on his stories, and maybe within in by this week we can make a good video, and we are hopeful for it.
Yeah, so absolutely.
For for making a documentary,
Farooq, one second, you know, let Tofail, you know, expand the story, you know, make him make him work on the story. Okay, you should only work on the video, but he have to push him, push him and push him to work on the story, so that the story, you know, has a full story. Okay, he has to know how to create the story, and you and me can help him on the video part, you know, because he doesn't have a laptop. We can help him on the video, but he has to write the story, even if it is writing it on a paper. You know, he can just take a paper screenshot and send it to us. Okay.
Okay. For Tofail, it will be like abstract thing. Just imagine that you are making a video, and okay, this script is moving there for 3 seconds and 4 seconds. Then, and you can imagine that, the children are playing, they are going to school, or we are showing schools or something, blah, blah. So when you have this thing in your mind, you have set up with your mind, then you can add, delete your script. When you are satisfied, then we can come together and do the video. Maybe you can, as we have limitation on laptop, we have only one laptop, we can sit together, and maybe sometimes I work on it, sometimes he work on it, so that he himself gain the knowledge of how to make the video with Lumion 5. I think it will be helpful.
Absolutely, Farooq, you just nailed it. This is exactly what I want to do. And to everybody else, you know, to Kasim, to Zunaid, to Shahida, you know, to Kiav, let me tell you, writing the story with the imagination is the most important thing, right? Everybody can do the next step, the video, putting the video. It's so easy. Ask Farooq. It's so easy. Yeah. You know, just drag, drop, you know, it's really nothing. Yeah. But writing the story, you know, the points, the moving, the audience, the impact, the drama, the hero of the story, the villain, the climax, the call to action, that's what is important.
Yeah? Sure.
So that's just one last thing before we go to your thing. You know, what I did, you know, so there is this thing I sent you, right? You remember, guys, I sent you this thing. Where is that thing? The school, online school.
Yeah.
Okay. So what I did, I created a small online school, okay, from Khan Academy, where you can actually go and join this class. This is for, you know, year one, year two. I can create, you know, classes for, you know, all sorts of people. Say, for example, you know, even adults who want to know about financial, personal finance, or who wants to learn about something else, you know, English or something like that, right? They can learn. So this is already a school. So let's say, you know, you are a student. Okay, so you can come and you can log in into your, you know, student thing. Okay, I have sent you a password, Cox student one, and Cox Bazaar is a password with a C capital, right? I already, Cox Bazaar, right? So this is a school for, you know, sorry, this is a class for just, you know, year one students, okay? This is not, you know, for, so if you come here, you'll be coming here. So your student can be your son's name or your actual people name, but I've just created Cox student. And if you come to courses, you know, you can look at all the courses. So I've just put one course so that, you know, you don't get overwhelmed. One course on maths, one course on English, right? This is for people in year one, year two, year three, you know, small children, right? So you can basically, you know, click on counting, how to do the counting. And you can basically, you know, do this, you know, step by step, right? So there is, you know, they check where you are. And then they basically, if you don't know what you're doing, then you can learn from this video, right? You know, so I mean, I'm not, you know, putting the thing, I don't know whether you can see the video, but you know, here is a video. Right?
Yeah, we can see the video. Yeah.
So it's very, very simple. Very, very simple. This is year one, right? So you can see the video, and then you can, you know, go back and answer these questions. So you learn from these videos. So you know it starts here, right? Counting starts with, you know, counting with small numbers, counting in order. Then you do this practice. Then you do these videos, you do this practice. Then you do this, and then you do a quiz. And then if you're good, then it goes to the next one. So if you see, you know, any one of your kids can do all of these counting in 1 week, right? Once you are finished with counting, then go back and do English. So this is English. Now, what is a noun? What is a verb? What is a pronoun? What is a modifier? So you can start the English course. Again, same thing, introduction to grammar, watch the English, to just 2 minute video. Everything is just 2 minutes, right? And then, you know, types of, you know, very good. Even I watch all these things, even though it is for, you know, children, I really, you know, did not learn many of these things when I was a child. So I go back and, you know, look at all these things and I learned a lot from these videos. It's extremely, extremely good. So this particular class I created just for year one people, just year one. Okay, I can do the same thing for year two. Okay, so look at this, second grade, third grade, fourth grade, you know, all these things. We can also do for, you know, people who want to understand personal finance, right? Economics, like adult people, right? History, computer science, right? You can also do adult courses. And this is all the kids, first standard kids, second standard, third standard, everybody is here, right? So it is very easy. I can create a, you know, a school for you, completely online school with you know, things that you can give it to your year one people, year two people separately, and you can learn from this. This is the place, you know, that the children of the billionaires are learning from. Like, I'm sure you guys know Bill Gates. I'll send you a video. Bill Gates said in a video that every day he and his children sit in front of this Khan Academy and they learn for 1 hour every day. So,
okay, I have one question here. You know, so far you created a student account. So what about the teacher's account? You know, in the student account, there are some preloaded tasks or video or lessons there. So when I am acting as a teacher, is there any scope that I create my own content and share there so that my student can participate? Or what will be the role of a teacher there?
Yeah, very good question. Very good question. Yeah. So now I have logged in as a teacher. Okay, so we can make you as a teacher. Okay, Farooq can be a teacher, Tofail can be a teacher, all of you guys can be teachers. See, this is the school I created.
Yeah.
Right, and these are the people, you know, in the students. Yeah. And this is the, you know, courses I have given them. You know, I've just given them little bit course, you know, like assignments. Their assignments are really small, right? Yeah. You know, like simple things. So I can assign more things.
Yeah.
So the role of a teacher is to assign what they need to study. Okay. So, you know, this is what I have created for you, right? So I can, you know, add more students. So, you know, for example, I can add new students like this.
Yeah.
Right. Like, you know, or I can just simply say, you know, student one. Student two, you know, I don't do this, you know, obviously, you know, give a nice name, whatever their name is. Yeah. And then you can create their password, you know, just create their password like this. Right. And then tell the student and them the password and everything, and they can come and, you know, log in for you. And they will then you can assign, you know, what courses you want them to, you know, take. Right. I will teach you this in a separate class, you know, Farooq. It's very easy to be a teacher. You can have multiple teachers doing multiple classes, and you can have thousands of students, you know, come to the platform and learn it. Okay, just is something. And also one last thing, whatever question you are saying, right? You know, can I create my own content? You honestly, you don't need to, but you can, but you don't need to. right? There is millions and millions of content available already here.
Yeah.
You know, so no reason for you to do that, but I will try to, teach you how to do the content also. I'll stop sharing. Now we'll come back to your question. You know, you had a question about documentary, right? Can you ask that question again?
Okay. You know, if we are trying to make a documentary on a specific Rohingya, so for example, the idea is where he had been living, how was his life back there, and how he migrated to Bangladesh, how it was during his migration. So what was the life like when he first arrived in Bangladesh, and how he is managing his life, and what is his future? So we want to make a documentary based of him. So my problem here is, you know, it's still like in every stages we need to put some footages. So that is why the
Farooq, I got the idea. I wanted to ask Kiav Naing, right? I don't know, do you have a question or something like that, because he was unmuting to ask, or I don't know. Kiav, right? Kiav or Yav Naing? No, he didn't have a question. Okay. So Farooq, I'm going to show you how to, do this. But if anybody has any question, just immediately ask, okay? Don't wait. Just interrupt and ask the question. So what you do here, right, Farooq? There is this thing called, come to media. Okay. See, it's the same thing for a documentary. You still have to write the entire story, okay? But instead of, uploading these videos are, already there, correct?
Yeah.
And one more thing, Farooq, never use this video which says marketplace.
Yeah.
And you see, this is money. So always use the video, that you can also untick this one so that, you never get that video. Okay. Because, if you use the marketplace video here, then it costs money. You understand? So don't use these videos. Now you can use any of these videos. Okay, number one. Number two, come to uploads. You see the word uploads here?
Yeah.
Come to uploads. Upload images and videos. Okay. And then let's say, you have created those videos, right? Whatever videos you have created, just select from your computer. And and then you can just put it over here. You understand what I'm saying? Can just put your computer and then. But the challenge for you is the videos that you have created, right? I saw the video that you created for the conference, right? Donors conference.
Yeah.
So you don't do that, like a 15-minute video, right? Just do 10 second video. So cut the videos already. Okay, so it is easy for you to, orchestrate the video here.
Got it.
Does that answer your question? So you can upload images also. Sometimes, you may not have good videos. Your videos may be of some very poor quality, but you might have very, very good images, of a Rohingya. I really never worry. I'll just go to, let's say, Rohingya things. I just go to images, right? These are really powerful images.
Yeah.
You can use these images. I know it is somebody else's images. You can always give credit to these guys, Al Jazeera, right? So let's say you want to use this image again. I will be very careful. Look at this image. Can you see this image is 800 by 450?
Yeah.
Right? I will not use this image because its quality is okay. It's not bad, but I will use, more larger images. So here, if you come to Google, settings, size, large. Okay. But it's okay. I think, any size also is okay, because there are much good pictures, in any size. So I could use this image, right? And when you are using this image, right, just make sure you give credit to UNHCR. Okay, let me tell you how to do this. Okay, say, let's say if you want to use this image, you click here. You can click here, save the image, right? And just give a name for this image, say Rohingya crossing river. Rohingya crossing river, okay? Just save it over there. Go back to your place. Now let's say you want to create a slide, documentary, and just add a thing, we crossed Bush or something like that, right? And then what do you do? Come here, upload, select the file. This is the file, Rohingya crossing the river. Okay, hey, very careful, okay? This is the place I want you to be careful. Yes. Can you see add credits?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, come here and say UNHCR. Why am I putting UNHCR? Go back to the image. This image is from UNHCR, can you see?
Yeah, UNHCR.
And it says images may be subject to copyright.
Yeah.
So you have to be very, very, very careful. You have to use the, you can use the image, but just mention the credit here. Okay. After mentioning the credit, you can upload it.
Yeah.
Okay. So once you have uploaded that image, the image will come here, or your video will come here. Always have the habit of giving credit to the people who created the video. Let's say Junaid has created a video, Kasim has created the video, right? It could be, and one more thing, video for everybody. Make sure, you always shoot your video on portrait, like this. Because all of us have the cell phone like this and we are always shooting the video, this way, isn't it? Sorry, maybe I'm telling it wrong. Just horizontal, always shoot horizontally.
Yeah. Like this?
Or is it not like particular?
Like this?
No, I'm not able to see it. One second. I'll have to pause this thing and come here. Just give me 1 second. Oops. How to come back? Yeah, tell me. Yeah, show me. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
This.
Yeah, always shoot like this image because it's really, because it is very distracting, to go from this to this and back, So always shoot, in that horizontal view. That's important. So I have added the thing. We crossed rivers have come here, right? This is clear. And one more thing.
UNHCR name is mentioned there, right?
Yeah, it will be. See, can you see? Yeah, it is mentioned here. UNHCR.
Yeah.
It's here.
Good.
Small Good. Thing. Okay, one more small learning we can do, Farooq and team. Is don't let the image flat. Right now it is flat. If you play the video, nothing much is happening, right? It's a very, very flat video, flat image. So what do you do? You can try to add some animation. Okay, I always like zoom in. But you might like something else, right? You understand?
Oh, yes. It's a new thing.
You can choose something else also, like pan up, pan down, but always make everything move. Always.
Yeah.
Even whether it's an image, whether it is anything you are putting, just make it move and make sure that you have it. Okay, that's the thing. There's one more last thing. I don't know whether there is also you can record your own voice. But this is a big lesson. I don't want to go into that. Don't worry about this. We will take it later on, because that's a big thing. How to record your voice? How to match your voice with the, with the moving image, right? It's very important that that is matched. Otherwise, it's very hard. Okay, any more questions, guys? Because we can, we are run out of time. It's really, we've taken more time. But I want to just pause here and Karthik, Noor, Shahida, you guys have any questions, any thoughts? Suchi, you have been very quiet, you know, but you can all unmute and ask me anything you want.
I've been listening. It's quite fascinating. It's my first time listening on how people doing videos. And I think you guys are surely very quite an expert in this area. And it's quite interesting to hear it for the first time.
Thanks, Susie. But to tell you the truth, you know, none of us are experts. I never knew how to create a video. I've never created video in my entire life. I learned how to create a video just like this, you know, maybe 2 years ago when we created Step Up. So honestly speaking, you know, even Farooq didn't know how to create video like this 2 weeks ago. And then in the last 2 weeks, he's already created two videos and posted it on Facebook already.
Wow. Right?
Nobody here is an expert. All of us are learning, pretending to be experts. We are really not experts. But we will become experts. I'm very, very sure we can become experts.
Yeah. Keep up the good work.
Yeah. Any other feedback, guys? Any other ideas?
Yeah. So this is Kasim. Can you hear me?
Very well, Kasim. Very well.
Yeah. So today I learned very interesting thing that is like short and simple, and simple word can be mean like the powerful. And like last meeting, we got like the how to make a story and like the how to complete a report, like 5 husband 5 wife, and also that one is like short and simple is very good, and also the duration is like the simple and 3 second 4 second, like this better short and simple for taking the scene for yes. The visual, and so that it be interesting, and also the we need to do the take the notebook and pen, write down the simple words, and people can understand easily, and don't make the confusion there to the audience, and otherwise they will be not interested. So I would like to say, Anis Bhai, today I learned very interesting thing from you and all you guys I saw on the screen, and thank you from my side. And Farooq also.
Yes. Kasim, you can't say only,
yes,
only thank you and go. I want to hear your story. I want to see your story, you know, in the next couple of days. So you
yes,
better
of
start.
Of course. Yeah, we are preparing also some line I already prepared, and also that I need to finalize and conclusion. So actually, like I am confused, like to file, so I how can I conclude my final one? What I would like to understand to people, what I would like to tell. So what I am telling, why, what do you want? So that is the thing. So maybe after someday I will send my script and also the with the video. I hope it will be.
Thank you.
Okay.
We will wait for.
I am going to unmute. Oh.
Yes. Anybody
great.
Else? Tofai?
Kasim, great.
Yeah, really great. Yes. Anyone else? Zunaid, Tofai, anybody wants to add anything? Noor, you wanted to say something? And Farooq, my wife is very angry. That none of the ladies are writing the stories. Where is all our women warriors? No, where are their stories? I mean, Shahida was there, Ali Nisa was there last time.
Lucky
was there. I want them to write also, you know, it looks like, you know, everybody.
Yeah. Shahida is beside me. You can ask them. They are listening to you also.
Yeah, I mean, Shahida, when are you going to write the story? And also Lucky, I'm not going to leave you guys.
Oh.
I will do this week.
And what story will you write, Shahida? What are you thinking? What is going on in mind?
I don't know, still I'm thinking.
Okay.
Yeah. So Shahida is a poet. He writes poetry. So I'm confused. She sent me a poem from her. Then I was really confused how to convert it to the video. Maybe we can think of it.
Yeah, poem is very, very difficult, right? You need to be very, very smart to convert a poem into a video.
Yeah.
It is very difficult, but you can do it. You can do it. It's very difficult.
Maybe first of all, she can write a story with contents of violence against women.
Oh, this will be like sexual gender-based violence, like things.
Oh yeah, he can raise boys for the women and girls who have been living here at camp, because he's one of the female who can raise boys for all of those.
Okay, that's good. See, people, you know, honestly, I'm willing to work with you, but you also have to, you know, work. You know, I don't like Farooq and Tofail and Zonaid alone working. I know these guys will anyway work without me also. You know, they will become famous even without me. But I want to make sure that everybody is working. You know, I want Shahida to write. I want Noor. I want Yao. I want Auzar. I want, you know, Kasim. I want all of you to write. You know, I don't want only Farooq to be, you know, writing and Zonaid to be writing. You know, it's really important that all of us, you know, put in the effort. It's very simple. It's just a simple story. You can be right, wrong, doesn't matter. Right? So we will meet in 2 weeks, but please don't wait for 2 weeks. Right? I want you to be active on WhatsApp, and I want you to put your story on WhatsApp. If you don't have a computer, no problem. Just write it on a piece of paper, take a picture, and put it on WhatsApp. Yeah? Because it's really easy for only Farooq and Zonaid and Tofail to keep on writing. It's easy because these guys know how to do it and they'll keep on doing. Very easy. But you have to do it. Other people have to do it. If all of you don't do it, then, you know, this is a failure. You have to do it.
Maybe okay. They are being busy. That's right.
No, yes. Yeah, I'm okay. I'm okay with that. But, you know, just start doing small things. Okay. I'm not in a hurry. But please show that, you know, you are working. That's all. You know, the fact that you are taking your time and coming and being here itself is very big. So, you know, you are interested, you are learning, but you also have to work a little bit more.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I will take leave now. I think, you know, it's a long, long time we've spoken.
Thank you.
We'll meet in 2 weeks. And I will try to send this video as a link, you know, so that you can relook at it if you want to, especially the first part, the storytelling part. If you want to relook at it, you know, just have a look at it. Okay. Shall we call it a day?
Oh, yeah. Thank you so much.
For me? Okay.
Yeah. Go ahead, Farooq.
Okay. I just want to make clear to all my members, especially from Noomar Film Schools, you know, whether they have any questions. If this is the greatest chance you can ask to Anis Bhai, and there are some guests as well. So it will be helpful. And, you know, there are some members who are just listening and watching us. Maybe they can speak, or either they can just give introduce themselves,
yeah.
Or say,
yeah. Who Farooq? Who are the other people?
You know, there are some new members, especially Ausarullah, Nur Kalam.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
They can.
I'm
and I have another one, Ayub Khan, and
Ayub Khan. Yeah, yeah. Yes, yes, yes.
They are in the conference today only. They come to know about Women 5 only today. So I think we can take feedback.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So Ausar, Ayub, Noor, you know, because you guys were not there in the last week, you know, do you have anything to say? It might look like some very fast session, you know. I can send you the link of the previous, you know, what Farooq we can do, right? The previous video, we can send it to them.
Yeah.
So that they can watch, you know, the previous one also. And then, you know, this new one also. So, you know the, any comments, Noor, Ayub? Any questions, comments?
So for Ayub and Noor Kalam and Ausarullah, if you want to speak, you need to unmute first and then you can
talk. Yes, also Yav. Anything you guys want to say? You know, I think everybody is very shy the first time. Maybe next week, you know, they will not have any shy. You know, this is just like, you know, we are all friends here. You know, no need to be shy.
Yeah.
You know, we just openly talk. But look, I spent nearly 2 years now with the Kakuma refugee camp, right? 2 years.
Yeah.
And for first 6 months, nobody spoke a word. You know, nobody spoke a word. Then I thought they don't know how to speak English. But now I can't stop making, I can't stop them from talking. They are like, you know, talking all the time. So I know, you know, it's a bit, you know, it, always the initial starting is a little bit, you know, tough. But have faith. We will keep meeting. We will keep learning.
Yeah.
But more importantly, we will also start earning, you know, because we don't want to keep learning. Nobody wants to just keep learning. We have to start earning money, which is our ultimate
goal.
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, actually, I would like to thank to all of you at first, because I'm first time here. I'm feeling nervous because I have never know about this application. I download from the Play Store, then I join it today. So I have learned a lot of things, how to make BDBs, how to make cartoons, and so many things.
Amazing.
So thank
amazing.
You.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for all of you for your hard work in here. Because I am very, actually, I would like to thank you a lot, because you guys all here to teach us something, and we have a lot. We have learned a lot.
Sure. Yeah. I think you can thank me when you start earning your money, you know, doing these things. Because there are a lot of people who are teaching, you know, you can learn all these things on YouTube itself. You don't really need me to learn. You know,
actually,
everything
yeah.
I teach, you know, it's there in YouTube, in some, even by better teachers than me. But what is important
yes.
is, why are we learning? We are learning this so that, you know, we can convert this into a skill, then earn money using the skill. You know, that's the most important thing.
Yes. When I joined in this application, I feel nervous. How can I talk here, and how can I share my feelings and emotion in front of all of the people, in front of all of the guys?
You know, you are doing very well, actually. You know, we can see everything and we can hear everything. So good.
You said here is some members, they cannot talk English, that way they keep silent. No, it doesn't mean someone is silent, they cannot speak English.
No problems. You know, we can take one step at a time. You know,
I'm still feeling nervous because I'm first time here.
Don't worry, Yav. Don't worry. You know, you'll be better.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Jonain, for talking and commenting on our sessions. And it will be very good if we guide you, and if we guide your video, and moreover if you joined us and talk about how we can progress in near future. So maybe we have Ayub Khan. He might need one to say something. Or if,
Yes, Ayub.
Maybe he is shying.
No, is he unmuted.
I think he is not unmuted. Ayub.
No, Ayub is unmuted. Ayub is unmuted. Let him talk.
His microphone is in problem.
Maybe.
Okay, maybe Nur Kalam. Nur Kalam. Okay. Maybe Anis bhai, we are taking a lot of time from you. Maybe if we don't have any others.
It's not a problem. It's not a problem.
Yeah.
It's not a problem. I really would like to hear from every single one of you, because it's important that, you know, we take everybody along, you know, only, not just, you know, Farooq. We have to take everybody together.
Sure.
So, you know, I really want everybody to talk, but that's okay. You know, if you're not able to do today, we will, you know, keep trying. And we will go together. We will travel together.
Sure.
Yes.
All right, guys. I will say bye bye. I'll see you guys in 2 weeks.
Thank you.
And stay safe in the meantime.
Bye bye.
See you.
Bye bye. Yeah, God bless you.
I don't know anyone. I just want to keep contacting with you guys.
Okay.
Yeah, there is a new friend. I don't know. Maybe first time I
actually talk. I am the friends. I am a friend of Tufail. I am the best friend of Tufail. He give me the links. Then I joined here.
Okay.
And next one.
Thank you.
Nur Kalam bhai.
Maybe.
Where is he?
He has left the conference. Nur Kalam is one of. Oh yeah, I can see you. Can you unmute? Unmute first.
Okay. Unmute first.
Hello. Hello. Yeah. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
To everyone from my side. How are you all of?
Yeah, we are okay.
Yeah.
I am new here. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I can't cook it so hard.
I'm warming.
I get this conference link from Farooq bhai.
Yeah, it's okay. We share it too a lot. Unwarming.
Okay, bye. Okay, everyone.
Oh, Anwar, me hotline.
You go.
Kartik Raja. Who is this guy?